Hello everyone, I'm Viet Le, an Associate Professor of Research at Intermountain Health and a Preventive Cardiology PA. In this video, we're going to talk about a space where PAs are uniquely positioned to make a huge impact, and that's in screening and early intervention in cardiovascular kidney metabolic syndrome, or CKM. CKM-related screening falls into two major categories. The first, the biological factors, things like metabolic risk, kidney function, and in some cases, subclinical atherosclerosis or cardiac dysfunction. The second set of risk factors really falls into social determinants of health. These are the social and structural barriers that affect lifestyle, self-care, access to care, and disease prevention. Today, we'll focus on the biological screening, but I encourage you to check the AHA's 2023 Presidential Advisory for tools to assess for SDOH. Now, risk factors for cardiovascular disease, they develop early, even in childhood. So here's what the AAPA and AHA recommend for pediatric patients. First is an annual screening for overweight or obesity and blood pressure starting at age 3. Mental and behavioral health assessments at least annually. Lipid panels between the ages of 9 to 11, and again repeated at 17 through 21. So for kids with overweight or obesity, screen for impaired glucose tolerance and an ALT to assess risk for type 2 diabetes and for metabolic liver disease. For adults, the AHA recommends the following: annual BMI and waist circumference measurements. For stage 0 CKM, then every 3 to 5 years. For stage 1 CKM, we should be screening every 2 to 3 years. As we get to stage 2 CKM, well, yearly checks of MET-S or metabolic syndrome components, blood pressure, triglycerides, HDL, glucose, plus a UACR and EGFR using serum creatinine or cystatin C. And then if a patient is in stage 3 CKM and has subclinical ASCVD or heart failure, they're at high absolute risk. This means that we should be considering intensified lifestyle and pharmacologic interventions. There are a few tools to help guide decisions, one of them being coronary artery calcium scoring in patients who have borderline or intermediate ASCVD risk. Screening early and regularly is especially critical for CKD, which often progresses silently. Let's quickly review a few of these tools. The first is UACR, or urine albumin to creatinine ratio. If the albumin is over 30 milligrams per gram, that could indicate kidney disease, even if EGFR is still greater than 60. EGFR estimation using serum creatinine or cystatin C helps stage CKD per KDIGO guidelines. Now let's talk about the KDIGO heat map. It's a visual tool that helps us understand CKD risk based on those two factors of albuminuria and GFR. We will start treatment when patients are at moderately increased risk. Referrals will typically happen when patients are at high or very high risk. But here's the key. Most of this is manageable in primary care. Whether you're in a clinic or specialty practice, PAs like us can make a real difference in early detection and preventive care. So to wrap up, early and frequent screening allows us to catch CKM progression before it becomes irreversible. In our next video, we'll dive into treatment options and how we can tailor care for these particular patients. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you at the next video.